Hey guys, today I thought I would show you really quickly how I paint my fingernails. I get a lot of questions if my fingernails are real, how I paint them, and today I thought I would show you really quick. My nails are all natural. Hopefully you can see this. This is very hard to film, but I don't have any acrylics, no kind of gel, overlays, nothing. It's my bare fingernails, and they are clean with one coat of base coat on them. You'll notice that I keep my thumbnails a little shorter, and that's just so that I can do more with my hands. It's easier. But yeah, so that's what basically all my fingernails look like. Today I'm going to do a gel manicure. This is not your typical gel manicure that you get at the salon. This does not have to be cured under a light. You just paint this on like regular fingernail polish, and it's from the drugstore. It's the Sally Hansen Miracle Gel Top Coat, and I'm going to use Blacky O. This color is gorgeous. One of the most important things you can do for a pretty manicure is taking care of your cuticles. I've been doing mine so long that they're naturally kind of permanently pushed back, but you can get like cuticle remover from Sally Hansen at the drugstore. Essie also makes a nice one, but once your nails get used to it, they will kind of permanently stay back, and having a clean cuticle is crucial to a pretty manicure. And basically what I do is I put the brush down towards the middle of the fingernail. Hopefully this is in focus. I put it towards the middle of the fingernail, I touch it to the nail, I move it to the base, and almost to where it's touching my cuticle, and I pull up in one stroke. Go right back down to the middle of the nail, swirl it around, and come up to the side of the nail. What you want to do is not go completely to the side of that nail. You want to leave just a little bit of space. So go back down to the middle, and then come around to the right side, and pull up in one motion. So that's what your first coat will look like. Down in the middle, almost to the edge, pull it up. Back down to the middle, swoop it around to the side, pull it up. Back down to the middle, pull it up to the other side, and around. So our first nail, first coat on the first hand is done. I am right-handed, so my right hand always looks worse because I'm not as good with painting with my left hand. Your second coat is always a lot easier than your first, and you can kind of catch any places you might have missed or fix any mistakes you might have made that second pass through. So we have our first coat, and usually what I do every time I do my nails, I start out with totally clean nails with nail polish remover, because even just touching your fingernails with your hand, you're going to transfer oils on your skin onto your nails, and that is going to affect how good your polish adheres to your nails. So with totally clean nails with nail polish remover, I push my cuticles back. I go over them again with nail polish remover to get the oils off, and then I do one coat of a base. My favorite is the Nail Teaks Formula 2. I do two coats of color, and I do one coat of top coat. No need to go to the salon, ladies. You can do your nails at home. You can have beautiful nails at home. Do them however often you like, with as many colors as you like. And really and truly walk away with a very professional looking manicure. So I'm gonna let this dry for a little bit. And then we will do the top coat that actually comes with this polish. My favorite is usually the Sesh Feet quick dry top coat, but this one does come with its own. So I'm just gonna give this a minute to dry. All right, and I'm gonna go ahead and do my top coat. And again, that is the one that matches this polish. They're probably not fully dry, but it'll be okay. And with your top coat, you wanna go, make sure you seal the edges, go all the way to the sides, but don't goop it up at the base of the nail. You see a lot of, I see a lot of like crusty clear coat. Don't let it get really thick there right at the base of your nail. Just a quick coat all the way down your nail. If you were wanting everything to be like perfect as soon as you did it, you could always take a Q-tip, cotton swab or something like that, and dip the end in a nail polish remover and clean up any little bitty touches that you get, like this little dot and this little dot. But otherwise, I mean, it's pretty good, and especially for an at-home manicure. So yeah, thank you all for watching this video. If you have any questions about any other things, I guess, to do with my nails, then let me know. I would be happy to do like a nail care video. I don't do very much to take care of my nails, but they are very healthy and I can grow them like as long as I want to. So yeah, thank you for watching today and have a good day. Happy Thanksgiving, guys.